Hey guys, welcome back to Happy TV. Today we're out on the M2. We have been blessed with some nice gorgeous weather. I've got the exhaust with me in the back. We're just gonna go to a nice spot that I know. Park up and just tell you a bit about it and why I went for it really. So welcome to my filming area for today's video. I don't really think you can argue saying it's pretty nice out here. It is quite busy. Not gonna lie to you, which is testing my confidence, so brilliant. Today I brought the car out here just to talk about my upcoming modification and maybe just a bit about my car itself, just because I haven't really spoke about it much. So I think without further ado, I'll get it out and show you this lovely bit of kit. So this is it, this midsection. It looks pretty funky. So. This bottom end here will connect up to my flexi pipes, or down pipes, I guess. And then it'll run underneath the car, and then it eventually connect onto my Miltec OFPF. They will need to cut my Miltec to make this fit, just because I think the Miltec comes up to about here. So they'll need to trim that back, and then they can use the connecting pipes that come with this pipe to then connect it onto these sections here. A couple of things that I want to make clear while I remember. When I was first looking at exhaust, when I first bought this car, I wasn't aware of all the complications and all the problems you can get. In my case, there wasn't really anyone who spoke about it that much. It was just like, oh, here's my new Active Auto Works exhaust, bash it on, that's it. And because these are made in the US, I know regulations are different out there, so it's not always as easy as you think. I bought a Miltec because I knew that it was just a chop and slide on system, and it wouldn't affect anything. And at the time, I didn't know that I could go for something like this. So one disclaimer that I will tell you is this will get rid of your OPF or PPF, whatever you want to call them. And once they're removed, you will need some sort of emulator or a map, basically, just to tell the sensor to allow for that different airflow. And obviously, if your car's newer and you haven't got you've got a few years left until your MOT, then that's fine. But when it comes to an MOT, legally you do need those OPFs or PPFs, whatever you want to call them. So that's the thing to bear in mind. I've heard really good things about them. I can't wait for this to be on and I actually hear it in person. I've only been sort of going off of videos and it sounds insane and they sound super loud. Which is what I want. I want a super loud, obnoxious little car. I don't really drive it much, so I want to make it so that every time I drive it, it is like the dog's bollocks, really. Just a little fact about Active Auto Works. So these guys started up in the US 41 years ago, I think. And they've been making high quality performance parts for BMWs in that time. So yeah, this whole system is all the way from the US. Pretty cool. It's like a wiggly worm, isn't it? So yeah, the guys at Active Auto Works basically made this pipe to work with either the M Performance exhaust, the stock exhaust, or they do an Active Auto Works cat-back system, basically. I know on their website they do have some disclaimers. So you've got to be careful which exhaust you use with what. If you're going to go ahead and you're going to have straight pipe downpipes from another company or from Active Auto Works, they recommend you use a resonated version of this, just because the whole point of this pipe was to eliminate that rasp. They recommend you use resonators if you have got straight through downpipes or aftermarket downpipes. If you're running stock downpipes, it's safe to use these. Or you can use a resonated version if you literally want no rasp at all. And BMW lovers out there aren't completely keen on that. If you've got a stock pipe with a cat-back, then get the non-res. But if you've got an aftermarket system, then maybe consider the resonated version. Obviously, you can follow my YouTube channel and you can see what mine sounds like with my Miltec. It could sound really I have no idea. Got a little mate there. If you've got the stock system and you're looking to upgrade with your M2, M3, M4, whatever, and you're not a fan of the udder or the nappy or whatever you want to call it, tit, whatever, ball bag is what I call it, then I would recommend looking to Remus Exhaust. I know that from speaking to someone who has a bit more knowledge, Remus Exhaust with these is a bit more of a slip-on job, so it's quite easy. Well, makes it easier. In my case, the Miltec hasn't been made for this. It's been made to work with the stock exhaust, and it's also an equal length system itself, so it has got a kink in it and all sorts like that, a bit like this one. So it's not as easy as just slipping it on. There is going to have to be some level of cutting and possibly welding in some places. I mean, I'm no good with that sort of thing. Right, now some time for some geeky, science-y shit. This system was engineered to basically get rid of that horrible rasp and just weird fart sounds that these S55 seem to make. Best way that they've explained it is that with the S55 in particular, when they put the two little turbos on it, it seems to sound like it runs like it has two 3 cylinders and not 1 6-cylinder. So it almost sounds like 2 3-cylinders are fighting together, and that's the noise you get, which I don't really think there's a better way to really explain it. So essentially what this is gonna do is this is gonna make those 2 3-cylinders, the 6-cylinder, work together and make a way better sound. It does look a bit weird. It does look like someone sort of welded some spare parts together and this is what came out, but this is what makes one of these sound so good. Essentially, you got one straighter side, one more kink side, and then they come over to the top, they go through the X pipe, and then they come to the connecting pipes, which then connect to whatever system you got from your axle backwards. And then, yeah, in theory, she sounds sick. Once the exhaust is on, then you're going to need some sort of you're going to need a map or an emulator of some sort to bypass that airflow sensor around your PPFs. I was looking into mapping, but obviously some people don't want to map their cars and have performance upgrades and all that, and I completely understand that. I'm not particularly worried into going into any performance upgrades just yet. There are a few bits that I want, like an intake and charge pipes and stuff like that, but nothing too serious. If you're one of those people that wants for it to sound good, you want to get the car set up right just so you can enjoy it how it is, then I would contact someone that can put this on for you and see if they can install an emulator. Speaking on power upgrades and everything like that, obviously going to a modded system, you are going to have some sort of difference there. So this is lighter than the old system. I can't tell you how much lighter, unfortunately, but I know that this is quite a good difference in weight. There is going to be a slight power increase to low to mid-range, and according to their website, the turbos can spool a bit quicker as well. If you do want to just keep it completely stock, then maybe this isn't the pipe for you, but just know that these engines are incredibly strong and they are literally pulled out of the M4 and M3, and they're running, I don't know how much more horsepower, 60, 70 horsepower over what this is. I think the M2CS is exactly the same car, kind of, but it's got the same engine, and that's got a different map on it, and that's got at least a 50 horsepower jump on this, I think. So yeah, you do get a couple of benefits out of it. You're not gonna get anything massive, which I think anyone with basic knowledge on cars knows that anyway. So yeah, it's quite loud. All right, so now we've got all the techie and the geeky shit out of the way. Let's talk money. At the end of the day, when you start doing performance mods, it's not cheap, and you know, you're gonna have to do it somehow. The Active Waterworks mid-pipe non-resonated version, I believe from M Performance, is around £2,000, maybe just under. I luckily got this on a Black Friday deal, so I got it for £1,500. Bargain. If you want the resonated version, I'm not sure if ML Performance sell that or not. I believe it's a few hundred quid difference. I think I would say another £300-400 on top. Then obviously, whatever exhaust you're going to run onwards from this matters as well. If you're going to run stock, then that's fine. You're going to go for an exhaust which you're going to stick on the end of that. Personally, I would go for the Remus Raceback exhaust if I could turn back time, which I think is about £2,000 to £2,500. And then obviously you got to get the thing fitted. In my case, I've got to have a couple of other bits done to it, is done to my Miltec as well, in order for it to be compatible with this. So mine's going to be a little bit more on the fitting side, but I've been quoted roughly around 100 quid-ish to fit the exhaust. And then the emulators are around £145 each, I believe. And I think you need two. So that's about £300-ish there. And then fitting's about 100 quid. So I think all be told, you'll be looking around £500 to actually get the exhaust installed onto your car, regardless whether you're getting another exhaust or not. So yeah, if you're gonna get the non-res like me and get it installed, then you'll probably be looking between £2,000, £2,500. If you're getting the resonated version, then add another £500 on top of that. And then if you're adding a Remus on with one of these, then you're probably looking at around £4,000 to £5,000. Depends if you can find the exhaust on a deal. If I were you, I would get it now while Black Friday is on ML Performance, because they've got some massive savings on a lot of stuff on there. If not, then just wait around, maybe a January sale, or try and look for secondhand, because they are big money, and you'd be surprised how much coin you can save if you wait till the right time of year. So yeah, ML Performance supplied me with mine. Thank you very much to you guys for that. When you do buy these, you do have to buy two gaskets, which is for the bottom end going on to your downpipes and flexi pipes. So you need to buy two gaskets, and you need to buy four nuts as well. I'll tag the product codes below for the exhaust and the gaskets and the bolts, and then that way you can look at that yourself and gauge what you need. So yeah, very excited for this to go on. I'm yet to book it in just yet. So start of the week, I'm gonna call up Auto Work Services and see when they can fit me in to fit this bad boy on. And I will be very, very excited. The only reason why I'm going into depth with something like this is just because the amount of videos I've watched on this exhaust, all this stuff after I bought it, or when I come to buy it, that I've only just realized, and I think, oh, for sake, why didn't someone tell me that? Or, you know, if only there were a video out there which told me that. So yeah, just bear this in mind when you buy this exhaust. It's not just a slip-on job. So you got this pipe, and then you got to choose what pipe you want to run there. And I think you've got BMW stock exhaust, M Performance exhaust, Remus race exhaust, and the Active Auto Works cutback system as well. I'm trying not to be blinded by the sun, but it's so bright. Hang on. Ah, it's better. So here she is. I'm going to run you through some of the mods that are on my car. It's not very long. A lot of it's cosmetic. Well, all of it's cosmetic, actually. Without further ado. Okay, so here is my lovely M2 competition in Hockenheim silver. So the reason why I went from one of these, I used to have a mini John Cooper Works F56, I think they are. The reason why I went for this one is because it had a lot of the mods already done on it, that which I wanted. Start off, we have the M Performance carbon fiber grille surround. Then we have the M Performance carbon fiber front splitter. We have the carbon fiber indicator vent thingies. This car's also fitted with the M Performance coilovers as well, so it is sitting a little bit lower than what they are from standard. So as we go down the car, we got your carbon fiber mirror caps, then you got your carbon fiber shark fin, come around to the back, carbon fiber lip spoiler, and the carbon fiber diffuser as well. On the rear, I think these are 15 mil, or are they 10 mil? 10 mil. 10 mil on the rear, 12 mil spacers on the front. Interior, we have, obviously we have the standard carbon fiber, which comes with the car anyway, the dry carbon. We've got the carbon fiber add-ons as well, which was the handbrake, the gear selector and the surround, and the steering wheel as well. So I just think that looks pretty cool. And it wasn't me. I don't really usually like these little like colored accents and stuff, but whoever had the car before me done that, and I thought it looked pretty cool, so I just left it. How could I forget? And then obviously you got your Miltec OPF equal length cutback system. That is a mouthful, isn't it? I got this exhaust installed like a month or two after I got the car, just because they're so quiet. And it completely changed my love for the car. It went from turning this car, which sounded like okay from the inside and shit from the outside, to making it a car which actually like gave you some joy when you drove it, just because it sounded so good. But now I've like up to the league again and I want to go for something better. So I'm really excited to feel that, have that feeling again of just connecting with the car, I guess. Anyway, guys, thank you for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it was a bit of a different style from the last few, but I need to break the ice. I need to get out there and start filming out in the country. Look at that. So yeah, I really hope you liked the video. Stay tuned for more mods to come. Obviously, I'm gonna have my exhaust going on very soon, which I'll keep you updated with anyway. Go ahead and follow me on Instagram and you should see all the updates on there, or TikTok as well. I should be making reels every now and again around when I post anyway. This is the bit I'm really shit at. Make sure you like, comment and subscribe. And if you fancy it, turn that bell notification on as well, so you know when I upload. I shall see you in the next one. Cheers, guys.